Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a photo of someone into a fractured photo portrait effect. Open a photo that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click like if you like this video. First, we'll separate our subject from its background. If you're using versions earlier than CC 2020, I'll show you what to do in a minute. For CC 2020 or later, click the lock icon to unlock the layer. Then, open the Properties panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Properties. Scroll down and click Remove Background. Photoshop automatically analyzes our image and makes a layer mask of our subject's shape. If you're using an earlier version, open the Quick Selection tool and drag it over your subject to select it. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To refine soft edges like hair, go to Select. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2018, click Refine Edge. If you're using CC 2018 or 2019, click Select and Mask. If you prefer to use Refine Edge, shift-click Select and Mask. I did in-depth tutorials on both of these filters, so if you want to watch them, I provided their links in my video's description. There are various view modes from which to choose. I'll choose Overlay, but feel free to use any of the others if you like. Check Smart Radius. This detects smooth and hard edges. To adjust the size of your brush, make sure the Caps Lock key isn't active and click the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over the edge of the hair and any other soft areas. Output it to a layer mask. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. We'll make a new layer below it by Control or Command clicking the New Layer icon. We'll fill it with a radial gradient, but first we need to fill it with a color. Let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. We'll fill the empty layer with either of these two colors. To fill it with the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. To fill it with the background color, press Control or Command plus Delete. I'll fill it with white. Double-click the layer to open its layer style window. Click Gradient Overlay. The blend mode is normal and the opacity is 100%. Check Reverse and align with layer. The angle is 180 degrees, and the scale is 130 degrees. Click the gradient bar, and in the gradient editor, click the foreground to background gradient preset thumbnail. Make your subject active. We'll be creating multiple copies of it, so to consolidate them, we'll place them into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Click the adjustment layer icon and click black and white. We'll be using an additional filter within the black and white adjustment layer. However, we want this filter to affect just our subject's layer inside the folder and not our background. Drag the adjustment layer above the folder. It's important to understand that an adjustment layer affects all the layers below it in the Layers panel. If we want it to affect just the one layer beneath it, we need to clip it or restrict it to that layer. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon or go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. In the presets list, there's a dozen predefined grayscale mixes from which to choose. Each one adjusts a specific level of grayscale brightness for different colors of the original image. For this photo, I'll use infrared. Make your subject active. We'll make numerous copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J for each copy. Make approximately 7 to 10 copies. I'll make 8. Temporarily hide the layers between the top and bottom copies so the only visible subject layers are the original subject and the top copy. Open your pen tool and go to an area outside your subject. Click once to make your first anchor point, release, and move your tool to another point. Click to make your first work path. If you want to reposition the path, press and hold Ctrl or Command as you drag the anchor point to a new location. Release and place your tool at another location. Click to make a second work path. Release and click back on your first anchor point to complete the path. Place your tool directly on the path and right-click or secondary click to open the flyout list. Click Make Selection and feather it 0 pixels. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Notice the subject and the layer mask are linked together. This means that if we reposition or resize either of them, the other will be repositioned and sized as well. Open your Move tool and make sure Auto Select is not checked. This prevents the wrong layer to become active in the Layers panel. Drag the layer to a new location. Notice the subject and the layer mask move together. That's because they're linked. If we click off the chain link icon to unlink them, we can move or resize either of them independently of the other. Whichever one is active is the one that can be adjusted. I'll make the subject active. Notice when I drag that area, the subject moves inside the stationary shape of the layer mask. I'll press Ctrl or Command Z to undo it. If we make the layer mask active, when we drag that area, the layer mask moves and our subject remains stationary. I'll undo this as well. For this layer, I'll keep them linked. Keep in mind, the shape layers that are above the others in the Layers panel will be visible on top of the other shapes on our subject. Make the layer below it visible and active. If you want to make a shape circular, open your Elliptical Marquee tool and make the feather radius 0 pixels. Place the tool on your subject and start dragging out. As you do, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift to snap the selection into a perfect circular shape from its center. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. I'll unlink them. Make the subject active. Press V to open back your Move tool and drag the subject. If you want to make the subject bigger or smaller inside the layer mask, press Ctrl or Command T to open the Transform tool. For this image, I want to increase the size of the subject from the center of the eye. To do this, I'll drag the axis point to the center of the eye. If you don't see the center axis point, go to Edit, Preferences, and Tools. Make sure Show Reference Point when using Transform is checked. Also, make sure the reference point is checked and that the dot is in the center. Go to a corner. If you're using CC 2019 or later, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it out or in. If you're using an earlier version, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it. Then press Enter or Return. Continue creating new shapes of your subject and layering them under each other using these techniques. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.